For International Women's Day, we asked some of our leading researchers to take a moment out of their extremely busy schedules to sit down and give some advice to the next generation of female scientists.
Hey, Milo, what's going on? Oh my God.
Here's what they had to say.
So when I got my start in science, it was actually quite challenging, and many people told me, are you sure you really want to do this?
It's really hard. And it's okay if you're not really strong in it at the beginning.
When you're first starting off, I must say, you know, most of your experiments fail. I remember having to do 10 experiments before getting that first one to actually work.
Oh boy. Do I have to guess specifics?
Oh, it was tough. But I think that's the point, right? Getting yourself back up and continuing to go and putting that smile on your face and realizing that if you push through, you'll succeed.
You need to have the lows to have the highs.
And just because it's hard for you does not mean it's not for you. If you have that desire to be in science and be in this field, you should pursue it no matter what.
I think one thing that's so important during your career as a scientist is to make sure you have good mentors.
I know in my life, mentors have been critical. I think it's critical to find people who are like-minded in how you think about science, but it's also critical to find those mentors that are personal mentors.
You're gonna hit bumps in the road and you're gonna need advice. It's really important that you have people who are more senior that you can reach out to and who are gonna look out for you.
Well, my dream is to see women very well represented across all areas of STEM. There are still areas of deficit, especially in leadership positions.
We need everybody on the table. We need a voice from everybody. We're starting to see more and more women in positions where they could be mentors, and I think that that helps advance the field.
Our work isn't always necessarily celebrated and recognized at the same level that work that some of our male colleagues do. So sometimes we have to help embrace and celebrate each other better.
The goal really is to eventually get to a point where we don't need to have awareness days, because everyone is already aware that, you know, we have a lot of women in science.